In our previous video, we had learned about a plastic. Types of plastic: thermosetting plastic and their example, thermoplastic and their examples. Let us discuss in our today class about properties of plastics. Do you know, children, plastic as you know materials offer many of us a choice. Today, if we think of storing a food item like a water, milk, pickles, dry food, you know, we prefer to use a plastic containers. This is because of their lightweight, lower price, good strength and easy handling. You know that being lighter as compared to metals, plastic are used in many purposes. So let us see what are the characteristics of plastics. Plastics are resistant to corrosion. Here, plastics do not get rusting as the iron and steel or other metals. Usually it get rust when it is exposed to the air or the water. But plastics are the materials which does not get corrosion. And plastics are resistant to high temperatures. You know, plastic is a non-reactive material. You know that metals like iron get rusted when left exposed to moisture or air. But plastic do not react with water and air. It is, you know, resistant to the high temperature. So due to this property, it has been used in cooking equipments and the electric appliances. And plastic is a insulator. It resistant to the heat and electricity. So we can say, like, you know, plastics are poor conductors of electricity and the heat. That is why electric wires have plastic covering and handles of screwdriver are made up of the plastics. So like this, even plastic is a good, you know, that a good insulator or poor conductor of the heat and electricity. Some of the plastics are elastic in nature and thermoplastics can be recycled. You know, plastic can be recycled and reused after it remolding or melted. It has been recycled, and plastic is non-reactive to the chemicals and the water. And you know, plastic is lightweight, strong and durable. You can talk to your parents or a grandparents about the, you know, the type of the bucket that were used in the past. Okay, so most of the buckets or mugs are used to be, you know, in the form of the plastics. Plastics is very light, strong and durable and can be molded into a different shape and size. So it is used for various purposes. You know that generally the plastics are cheaper than the metals. So due to it, its cost or durability, moldability, plastic has been used for many purposes. And plastic is a water resistant and even it is soft when it is hot. So due to this reason, plastics are a choice of a material in our today life. Okay, students, understood? There are different properties of the plastics, as resistant to the corrosion, resistant to the high temperature, and plastic is an insulator for heat and electricity, and plastics are the elastic in nature, thermoplastics can be recycled, and plastic is non-reactive to the chemicals and water resistant, soft when it is hot. Even plastic is light, strong and durable. But children, you know that plastic, uses of the many plastic articles in our daily life, it is going to affect to the environment. You know, when we go to the market, we usually get things wrapped in a plastic or a packet, in a polythene bag. That is one reason why plastic waste keep getting accumulated in our house. Ultimately, plastic find its way to the garbage. So once we use this polythene bags or the plastic wrappers, it has been thrown in the garbage. But what is the disposal of the plastic? You know, how to dispose the plastic articles? It becomes one of the major problem, and it is going to create a effect to the environment. So it is very necessary for us being a responsible citizen. It is very necessary to show a very sharp mind that materials which get disposed with a proper way. So recycling a waste plastic is very important. It may kill many animals as well as polluting earth. Okay, so this is what one of the main drawback of the usage of the plastic. You know, plastics are non-biodegradable. The meaning of non-biodegradable and biodegradable, I think you might have studied in a previous class that biodegradable and non-biodegradable. Here, plastic is a non-biodegradable. It means biodegradable, the meaning of that is a material which get decomposed through a natural process such as action by a bacteria, right? The material which easily decomposes are said to be a biodegradable, but the plastic act as a non-biodegradable, means this plastic material which is not easily decomposed by any natural processes. So that is what plastic are said to be a non-biodegradable. And since plastic takes several years to decompose, it is not environment friendly, it is not eco-friendly, it cause environmental pollutions. You know, if you burn the plastic or any synthetic material, it is what it is going to be cause air pollution. If you thrown on a land, it never decompose, it take us several years to decompose. Okay, so you know that many reason to avoid the plastics. Few years ago, scientists have discovered photodegradable plastic that can be broken down by sunlight. Photo in the sense, the sunlight. But it takes a very long time to rot or decompose. Even after inventing the different type of the plastic, that is photodegradable plastic also, it takes a very long time to decompose. Recently, scientists developed biopolymers, that is biodegradable polymers. They rot very easily. For example, plastics made from corn starch. Your corn starch is what the starch usually which we get it from the plant, and dissolves rapidly in water. So due to the environmental effect, scientists have started to develop a biodegradable polymers. Okay, students, please avoid the usage of the plastic as far as possible, and make use of bags are made up of cotton or jute when you are going for the shopping, because we are the people where we can protect our environment. If you protect the environment, and the environment is going to protect us. So it is what? It is our responsibility to protect the environment. As a responsible citizen, please remember 5R principle. That is reduce, reuse, recycle, recover and refuse. Okay. And please develop the habits which are environmental friendly. So students, understood? Today we have discussed the different properties of a plastic, and how the plastic being affected to the environment and what are the major actions to be taken to protect our environment. Please avoid usage of the plastic instead of the plastic. You know, already the government of India has banned usage of the plastic, the polythene carry bags. You know, instead of giving the pack, you know, in the shopping mall or any other grocery shop, any other shop, they are providing a jute bag or a cotton bag or paper bags. So this is what our responsible habit to create a eco-friendly environment. I hope you have understood, and I believe that you people are going to help for making a eco-friendly environment. Thank you.